So here we go, the F1 2016 available now for Android. The info first, maybe. So we've got weekly event. So that's like a weekly time trial by looking at. No. So we're going to pick a trial. Sounds like a time trial. That's also a time trial. Maybe that's an individual one. Options, custom season. Race weekend. Enter different sessions over an entire F1 weekend. Obviously now the season's finished, so it's not going to be valid, I wouldn't have thought. Quick race, you can have just a race wherever you want. That sounds a good idea. You can do the season. Right, so we're going to have a look first at the options. The first thing I'll do is to turn that music off. I'll turn it right down. Effects, I think I'll have that on max. Voiceover, so do we want to be the engineer? Yeah, I think we do. Subtitles, on or off, I'm going to leave them off, but that's a brilliant idea to have subtitles. That is a brilliant idea. General, text, English. Facebook Connect, no, not doing that. Google Play, I've already got that, I think. Right, Speedo, I'm going to leave that in MPH, I think. Modify your game settings. So where's the controllers? Obviously, look like it's on there. I don't know where the controller's going to be. Right, so we just go for quick race. Australia, I'm going to go and choose. I've got Catalonia. Oh, lovely. We've got Monaco. That'll be excellent. I'm going to go Silverstone, actually, where's Germany? If that's Hockenheim, I'm going to go for Germany, Hockenheimring. Info or random? Info. Right, so that tells you a little bit about the track itself. So it's our entire selection, super soft. I don't know what you can change and what you can't on it as yet. Oh, Spa. I want Spa. I'm going Spa. Right, now you can choose what team you want. And it's got all of the teams in it. So you can pretend you are whoever you want to be. I would imagine majority of the people are going to go for obviously Hamilton, Rosberg, maybe Verstappen. Do we go for, I'm going to go Ferrari actually. He doesn't look very happy, does he? Oh, Kimi. Now he looks exactly what you think. He's got the right ump most of the time. That suits me. I'll be Kimi. Right, race distance. Three laps to do. A1 driver level, easy. And how many laps can we do? Oh, you can actually go up to 44 laps if you so desire. Three laps will do, I think. Damage. So you got full, reduced, or off. I think to start with, I probably should go with damage off, as I don't know what I'm doing. Start session. Everything about this for me is going to be what the graphics are like. Man, that looks old. I hope that gets a bit better than that. That looks the car looks good, but the track looks like it's 20 years out of date. Controls, tilt. Obviously I want to go tilt. Accelerate manual, brake manual, so I'll choose that one. Steering assist, height, braking assist, Dynamic racing 9. I don't want racing 9 turn that off. Braking assist. I don't want, actually I'll have that on low maybe. And steering assist, I'll have that on low. Steering sensitivity. I don't know what's I think I'll leave both of them in the middle and then play about with them as I go maybe. Right, we're cooking. Where am I starting? Tire, super soft, can we change that? No, hang on, car setup. Current type, super soft. Change tire. Obviously it's gonna go for longer. I don't know if you can do a pit stop in here. That'd be interesting to find out. Aerodynamics, top speed. So if you make that, right, so it's bang in the middle, so the car's nicely balanced, as it is, you would think. Objective is to get to third. It's got like a horizon tilt on it, which is not good. Well, I've only been going 5 seconds and straight away I must say this looks really old. I certainly don't like the camera tilt on it. This looks like something from just definitely looks like something from 20 years ago. I'm actually pretty disappointed with this already. The setup I've got, easy to drive, but the steering, it doesn't actually seem to turn the wheels. It's like the car, the whole car just sinks to the right or to the left. A little bit more like you'd expect with a motorbike rather than a car. I mean, these cars are really stable, but it's the whole thing goes, I'm not liking it. The main thing is the graphics are just, they're bright and vibrant, but the gameplay is, it's nothing short of horrible, if I'm honest. What, where's the pause button? I need to get rid of that horizon tilt if I can. What if I can get rid of camera tilt? Well, I need to get rid of that. That is horrible. Steering sensitivity. I think that will probably need to go up. I want to try that. That has got to be better because that was horrible. Resume. I didn't like that camera horizon tilt. Right, that's much better. Audio wise is old fashioned. It's certainly nothing like Real Racing 3, that is a dead cert. All the crowd are obviously all in 2D. You should be able to take it. Alright, this is because I've got all the assists on, isn't it? It was braking there, you don't see them brake in real life at that O-Roost, they just go straight through there flat out. What happened there? I had no idea what happened there. What happened there? The engine, it sounded like the engine cut out. Right, so the steering now of the car is, it's really hard to turn. I'm actually then going to restart it as well because now I've got the control somewhere where I like it. That will suit me. see what that's like from the beginning.
Come to the Circuit de Spa-Francorchamps, which is the location for today's.
I mean, that there doesn't look particularly good. The car, it looks like the car is of a game now, which is brilliant. But the backdrop of everything else is like it's from, as I say, 20 years ago. Can we see out the rear view mirror? Oh, we've got a camera there. What other views have we got? Right, now the car is weaving about something terrible. The graphics on that steering wheel are shockingly bad. I need to turn that down again a little bit. I'm just trying to get this so I can feel like I'm in control of it, which is... Why have I got the braking assist and the steering assist on again? I thought I'd turn it off. Well, everything off, and that is going to go down to about 8 for the steering sensitivity. I thought I turned all that stuff off. Maybe I'm going mad. This actually cost... Well, that's not turning now. This cost $10. I mean, there's nothing about... Right, that doesn't turn at all now for some reason. That's not turning at all. Maybe I've got to put steering assist on medium, because that just didn't seem to be turning at all. Still doesn't want to turn. Well, it feels like I've got a puncher. Regardless of whether I win or even if I can compete or not initially. Right, so the car doesn't turn. Why is the car not turning? It's more about the actual gameplay of it and visually, what it visually looks like. Steering assist. Right, so it looks like I might have to have that on high. It doesn't look like I can drive it otherwise. It still seems to be very difficult to turn the wheel. Roger. Right, should be flat out through here. Will it break for me? I can't seem to get it to turn to go round a corner. It's as though there's no lock at all on the steering. It seems like the steering will just turn just a tiny... So the thing is there, when you look at the steering wheel on the car itself, on other car games, Real Racing 3, I'm thinking about. As I turn the device, it turns the same as that. Whereas when I'm turning the wheel, sorry, when I'm tilting the device on here, it's not matching what's happening on that at all. It's definitely something to do with this, the way this is done. So if I'm going to turn the steering sensitivity right down and try that. Is that any better? No, it cuts out there at Blanchimont. Right, so that slid off. Now I was tilting a device hard left there and that was going nowhere. Now it's hard right and it's going nowhere. The steering seems to be wandering about and doing exactly what it wants to. It doesn't seem to have hardly any input from me whatsoever. Try that on halfway. The engine's cut out again. I think I've had enough of that. I'm going to retire that. So first few laps is try out there with a game. Extremely, extremely disappointed. Right, graphics wise, the highly anticipated really old again. The car itself, down on the grid. Nice and modern. Some of the stands look okay. But it seems to be the curbing and well, you can get straight in and play the game. If you're not that worried about good graphics and you want the story more than the gameplay and stuff, then it'd be, you know, it's a good game, I suppose. But for it cost $10, £7.99 in pounds. But bearing in mind, you haven't then got to start spending the in-app purchases like you have on most games. The actual driving of the car seems to be really, really just sort of guesswork. You feel like you're in control and then you've got no control whatsoever. It seems to be you got to come to a stop, and then the steering wheel has got no play at all. Then it's got loads of play, and then it's got none. It's really, there doesn't seem to be any consistency with it. It only seems to turn once you've come off the brake. If you've got the brake on at a time, you can't turn at the same time, is what it seems. What speed are we getting up to? 200. It's got some good markers for your braking distances here. The signage is good. The trees don't look bad. What's letting it down for me is it's not very smooth driving it, and I've tried lots of different settings now. I know I'm new at it, but not very smooth. It's very, so it just seems to be very inconsistent. It's snatching the wheel away from it, right and left. You've then got really light steering, then you've got extremely heavy steering, and it all seems to happen within a few seconds of each other.
Sorry about that, I guess it can't all go to plan. Bring her in.
Weekend into reality. It's time for the Italian Grand Prix.
Car setup, can I do anything with that? Aerodynamics. Now, it's not a twisty circuit, so you don't really want cornering speed. I think that should be quite good on the middle version there. Right, that steering wheel looks a lot better than it did in the Ferrari. Right, the graphics of the cars, left that too late, didn't I? Graphics of the car in the mirror, not terrible. This is like you've got no traction and all of a sudden traction grabs. I was going to come off of the try without crashing. I was just seeing if it's similar to Real Racing 3, where you come off of the accelerator but the downforce of the car slows you down. This doesn't appear to have the same setup as that. You have definitely got to brake it, whereas the F1 cars and Real Racing 3, you don't have to brake it. The aerodynamics will do that for you. Well, I've overtaken one car. Right, so the things that I've found out so far are that you have to brake. Aerodynamics won't do it for you. The steering is horrible on all settings. This is pretty much like they've made a brand new game to look really old. It's not good. The gameplay is just not smooth at all. It looks like in another few versions time it might be fine, but at the moment I'd say it's not worth $2, let alone $10. I was going to try one little bit at Monaco, so I'm not bothered about winning whatsoever.
This is a really good starting
position. I'm up at the front.
Let's try not to lose it.
Steering wheel, not bad. So that's surprising. I totally missed that first corner. And yet only one person overtook me. Right, so of all the tracks that I've tried, and I've only tried about four or five, this is far better looking than the others, far better looking. And I should actually have set this up for cornering. I don't know if that would have set it up for you, but all the others have just been on the middle setting, which is cornering or top speed, and it's just been in the middle. So this one where there's lots of cornering, you obviously should have said it, the bias would need to go towards the cornering and not the top speed one. Actually, I might actually retire that and just have a little look on the... If I restart, can I set it up?
Race day here.
Car set up, that's what I want to look at. Right, so cornering speed. So that should give you more grips, I would think. It's now going to give you loads of grip. Right, so now I've got better cornering. Apparently I've got better cornering. He obviously got away at the start much better than me. Right, so maybe this is, rather than the steering itself, this is what you've got to gear up for, because this, although I'm driving this extremely badly, it feels like I've now got a lot more control through turning that setting on the, towards the cornering rather than the, rather on the top speed. We'll cut across there, no one will notice. Now obviously with some practice you would definitely get better. This track is the first track that I've tried that I could have a few laps. This is just, it is just so hit and miss with the steering being light 1 second, and you just seem to be fighting it all the time. It's really hard to remember to not brake and make any movement on the steering at the same time, because you are going to be off. You've definitely got to brake and then steer once you've stopped braking. This is far, far better than... Oh, I've gone across the corner again. Ah, shut your face. If only the driving was smoother and more consistent, and rather than being just totally and utterly erratic, and this was the benchmark of what the tracks look like, it would be a 7 or 8 out of 10 game. But as it is, it is hard work to drive it. Visually quite poor. I'm in two minds now whether to uninstall it or not uninstall it. This track is is the big, big plus point with the game. Spa was not good. Hockenheim was not good. You certainly feel like you've got to wrestle this car to actually get it around a track. Far more enjoyable than the other tracks. It's honestly just the how difficult, how choppy the steering is. You've got no faith in it, whatever you do with it. And I've changed the settings as many times as I can think of, and it's just poor driving, it seems to me. And the graphics are nothing like what I expected. So for me, I've only touched the surface of the game, obviously, but I must say I'm not really liking it, if I'm honest. But you know, what's through the view? Right, so this is going to be a whole sentence. This is going to go through a whole lot of tracks. And can you pick them in order, I wonder? So you've got practice, qualifying, and race. Doesn't matter what setting I put it on, it all seems to be not right. There's no consistency to it, which is that keeps pulling right for some reason. Well, remember, don't brake and steer at the same time, because that doesn't work. It's like the car is set up to go right. Now, if the track's got a lot more right turns than left, then that would obviously make sense, but is that going to brake? Is it going to steer and brake for me again? Change that camera angle. Graphics wise, again, looks very, very old fashioned. It's like something that you might have got on a PlayStation 2 or even a 1. Sega Mega Drive. I made the mistake there of braking and turning at the same time again. That doesn't work. Right, that actually feels a lot easier to drive, but what is my setup on here? I'm sure the thing just changes and does whatever it wants, you know. This camera tilt, I'm going to turn it up, because that, I think, will make it horrible. I was going to see what it looks like. Oh, come on. So what is that meant to replicate? That feels like it's going the wrong way from what would actually happen. I mean, if he was going round to the right there, it would be leaning to the right, not to the left. They've got it round the wrong way, surely. Right, so if you're going left, you would... Oh, I don't know. This is... Now strangely, it's driving easier with this tilt on. I've no idea why that would be. But it actually seems to be a lot more in control with this tilt on. That makes no sense. Right, I don't like that at all. Right, so that's going to be, if I press the right button, quit that. So for me, in summary, is do I like the game? No. Is it worth $10? No. Good points are the story. Bad points are virtually everything else. Actually, no, the other good point, it was Monaco. That was quite nice. I honestly don't like anything else about the game. I wish I did, but unfortunately I don't. So, but anyway, make your own mind up, see how you get on with it. But it's $10 in the Android store now. Let me know what you think, if you buy it, what you think of it. Good luck, cheers.